So, very good morning to all. So today, this topic is some problems commonly associated with canned fishery products. So this topic is under the course of fish canning technology. So in canning technology, we are preparing different kinds of canned fishery products. So while preparing, after preparation of this canned fishery products, we will face some problems, and which is commonly associated with canned fishery products. So several problem is there, shortening is there, musk is there, retort burn is there, then blue discoloration is there, curd formation is there. So we will go one by one. First is struvite formation. So this struvite, basically it is associated with brine packed shrimp, crab or tuna, canned marine products which is packed in a brine. Say for example, shrimp in brine, crab in brine or tuna in brine. So if these products are packed in a brine and then we are forming a canned product, so it will show some problem. So that problem is struvite formation. So this struvite will look like a glass like crystals. You can see here the this photograph. So this here you can see the glass like crystals. And this formation will be enhanced when the storage temperature will be low. At that time, it will form a glass-like crystals or struvite. So what is the causes? Causes to form a struvite formation in brine in shrimp in brine, then crab in brine or tuna in brine. So basically due to the formation of a chemical compound. What is the name of that compound? This is magnesium ammonium phosphate hexahydrate. So this magnesium ammonium phosphate hexahydrate, how it is means formed inside that can. So this magnesium, it is coming from the salt, because brine is there. How we are preparing a brine? We are preparing a brine with this salt. We are using the salt and water. If we are mixing with two, then we are forming a brine. So this magnesium is coming from the brine or seawater or salt, we can say. Okay, so this magnesium will combine with ammonia, and this ammonia will be liberated during thermal processing while we are loading our can into the retort. So that times ammonia will form from the fish muscles, because fish is a source of protein. So protein will degrade or ammonia will be liberated. So this magnesium will combine with ammonia and the phosphate. Phosphate from the fish, they will combine and then it will form a magnesium ammonium phosphate hexahydrate. This is basically called as struvite. It's a glass-like crystals. So that mechanism I already told. Basically, this struvite is a harmless, colorless, odorless, transparent chemical glass-like structure. But if it is present into the can, then it is considered as objectionable. Means objection hamara lag jayega. Suppose can ka jab hum taste karenge, if it is formed, struvite formation is there inside the can, so consignment will be rejected, because this is the problem which is formed into the brine, shrimp in brine, crab in brine, tuna in brine. So in that product, if it is forming, so that is objectionable. Okay, and this struvite, whatever the problem is there, it is very important. in your ZRF exam, SRF exam, ARS exam, all this will come. Strobite, especially that magnesium ammonium phosphate hexahydrate, chemical strobite formation. You can see here, the scan is there. On the top, you can see that crystal, glass-like crystal. You can see glass-like crystals.
Yes, sir.
But it is harmless. But physically, if we are seeing, because of that, it is considered as a objectionable in canned product. Because it is a chemical compound, magnesium ammonium phosphate hexahydrate. This is microscopic one. You can see bigger ice, sorry, glass crystal. So this is your strobite. Then another one is the sulfide blackening. This is also important, most commonly come in your competitive exam. So this sulfide blackening is usually associated with a canned shrimp, canned lobster, canned crab. Okay. What is the causes? Causes is because of the formation of iron sulfide. How this iron sulfide will form? Because you can see here, this is your tin. Sorry, this is your can. Can, you can see there is a scratch. Because if you see this can, how it is formed, we are having a base plate. So base plate, we are having steel or iron, we can say. On that steel or iron, we are applying a tin iron alloy layer. On that, we are applying tin free layer. And above that, preservative oil film and oil film, or lastly, we are applying a lacquer. Basically, in canned fish, we are applying, if the can which is used for fish, then that can should be sulfur resistance. Lacquer should be SR. SR is the sulfur resistant lacquer. In case of fruit can, we are applying AR. AR is the acid resistance lacquer. But in fish can, we are using sulfur resistance SR lacquer. Okay. So, how you can see any scratches if it is occurring on the can surface. Can surface, if it is scratching is occurring, so what will happen? Lacquer will remove, so it will expose the tin layer. Okay? Tin layer will be exposed. And if the tin layer is exposed, because this is our marine product, marine fishes, they are having a rich in trimethylamine oxide in their muscles. So this trimethylamine will act on tin and it will dissolve. So if the tin is dissolved, then last layer is iron. So this iron is exposed. And during the retorting or thermal processing, that fish is a rich source of protein. They are having all the essential amino acids, especially the sulfur containing amino acids will liberate a sulfur during retorting or thermal processing. So this sulfur will react with iron to form a iron sulfide. And that, if the iron sulfide is formed, that is black in color. So that is also objectionable if it is formed. So if can mein form ho jayenge black spot agar hum ye dekhenge to ajeeb se lagega na. So that's why it is also objectionable. So this mechanism already I told. So then what is the preventive measure? How we can prevent? Preventive is that we have to use uniform lacquer, and that lacquer should be sulfur resistant. सल्फर रेजिस्टेंस लेकर रहेगा तो वो लेकर हमें यूज करना है. एंड देन हाउ दिस स्क्रैचेस इज अकरिंग ऑन द टिन, सो ऑन द कैन सरफेस, सो केयरफुल हैंडलिंग इज रिक्वायर्ड. to avoid any scratches, to prevent the exposure of iron. Then we have to also maintain a proper acidity and use a parchment lining. Parchment lining, you can see here, this is your can. So can. Can is there. So one paper like this lining is there. So we have to cut this parchment lining, means paper, and we have to keep into the can, either on the bottom or on the side. You can see here why we are placing this parchment lining, because during the handling process there should not be any scratches. During handling operation agar scratches ho jayenge to kya hoga, lacquer hamara hat jayega, lacquer hat jayega to tin expose ho jayega, tin expose ho jayega तो ट्राइमिथाइल अमीन जो कि मरीन फिश में पाए जाते हैं, दिस ट्राइमिथाइल अमीन विल एक्ट ऑन द टीन, वो टीन को क्या करेंगे, डिसॉल्व कर देंगे एंड देन आयरन एक्सपोज हो जाएंगे. ओके, दैट्स व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग दिस पार्चमेंट लाइन टू प्रिवेंट द स्क्रैचेस ऑन द लैकर. अंडरस्टूड? दिस इज ऑल्सो इंपॉर्टेंट, मोस्ट कॉमनली कम इन कॉम्पिटेटिव एग्जाम. ठीक है, आगे चलें.
यस सर. सर एक बार फिर से सर, आवाज नहीं आ रहा था.
आवाज नहीं आ रहा
है? यस सर, बारिश हो रहा है ना, नेटवर्क का बहुत इशू हो रहा है सर.
अच्छा ठीक है, हम फिर से बता रहे हैं. ये सल्फाइड ब्लैकनिंग जनरली हमें कैंड श्रिंप में, कैंड लॉबस्टर में, कैंड क्रैब में और अदर मरीन फिश जो होते हैं उसमें ये हमारा मोस्ट कॉमनली मींस अकर होते हैं. मोस्ट कॉमनली उसमें सल्फाइड ब्लैकनिंग होते हैं. ये सल्फाइड ब्लैकनिंग कैसे होते हैं? बिकॉज वी आर हैविंग ए कैन, ऑन द कैन सरफेस देयर इज अ लैकर. सो इफ एनी स्क्रैचेस इज अकरिंग ऑन द लैकर, सो व्हाट विल हैपन, tin surface will expose, tin surface will expose, and during the thermal processing, because it is a marine fish, marine fish is having a trimethylamine in their muscles, so this will be liberated during the thermal processing, and this trimethylamine will act on the tin. Okay, if trimethylamine is acting on the tin, it will dissolve. That means tin will dissolve. And if the tin is dissolved, मतलब पूरा tin का जो layer था, वो layer हमारा पूरा dissolve हो गया. Dissolve हो गया, तो हमारा जो last वाला जो base plate है हमारा, that is made up of iron, that is made up of steel. So this iron will be there. And during the thermal processing, also the sulfur will released. From where the sulfur is coming? Because fish is a rich source of protein, and this protein is having all the essential amino acids. So especially the sulfur containing amino acid will be liberated. Sulfur compound. This sulfur containing amino acid will liberate sulfur during thermal processing. So this sulfur will act on or combine or react with iron, and it is forming the iron sulfide. So this iron sulfide, if it is formed, then you will see that black color is there. If black color is occurring, so that is because of the iron sulfide. So that is called as sulfide blackening. So how we have to prevent this sulfide blackening? First of all, we have to use the uniform lacquering. So whatever lacquer we are using on the can surface, inside the can we are using, you can see this is the inside the can. So inside can, that lacquer if we are using, that should be sulfur resistance. That means If any sulfur compound is liberated during the thermal processing, so it is not going to means affect on the lacquer. That's why we are using a sulfur resistance lacquer. That is the first preventive measure. Second, we have to do careful handling. Careful handling because how this scratches is occurring. Agar hum can use kar rahe hain, koi le ja ke patak raha hai, ya fir kuch during cleaning ke samay mein hamara ho sakta hai scratch lag gaya. So that's why we have to do careful handling. Then next preventive measure is that we have to use parchment lining. What is parchment lining? You can see there is a parchment lining. This is the parchment lining. So we have to cut whatever the diameter of the can is there. So bottom of the can we are using this parchment lining, and also the side of the can. You can see cutting process and how we can measure the side of this. So from bottom and side we are covering a layer, that is or lining, we can say this parchment lining. ठीक है
सर
बोलो
सर parchment lining क्या चीज से बनाया जाता है कौन से मटेरियल से
पेपर जैसे बटर पेपर है ना जब हम खाते हैं होटल में या रेस्टोरेंट में तो देखेंगे हमको कोई प्लेट ऐसा होता है अगर लिक्विड आइटम जाएगा तो क्या होता है वो लिक्विड हमारा पेपर एब्जॉर्ब कर लेता है ना बट बटर पेपर जो होते हैं उसमें अगर हम लिक्विड डालेंगे भी तो वो लिक्विड हमारा मतलब पेपर एब्जॉर्ब नहीं कर पाएगा बिकॉज देयर इज अ बटर लाइनिंग सो लाइक दैट वी आर हैविंग अ पेपर सो दैट पेपर वी आर यूजिंग दैट इज द पर्चमेंट लाइनिंग ठीक है व्हाई वी आर यूजिंग टू प्रिवेंट द एनी scratches
sulfide yes
given the sulfide back understood
yes sir
aage badhe
yes sir
then another one is the curd everyone is knowing curd
Yes, sir.
Curd, you know, na curd. So curd and adhesion, basically in canned salmon. Basically, curd and adhesion phenomena we are facing in the canned salmon. Canned salmon, how this curd is formed? Because due to the formation of the curd. Then what is curd? Curd basically it is a salt soluble protein because if we are using a brine so what will happen brine is a salt solution so if we are dipping our fish meat into that brine so whatever the salt soluble protein will be there that protein will be exuded matlab bahar nikal jayenge and it will be coagulated and precipitated during the thermal processing agar fish hamara stale fish hai agar pehle se hi raw fish jo hum use kar rahe hain agar fresh nahi hai stale fish hai so we can face the problem of this curd and also inadequate brining or pre-cooking अगर प्री कुकिंग अच्छे से नहीं करेंगे तो डेफिनेटली वी विल फेस ए प्रॉब्लम ऑफ कर्ड फॉर्मेशन इन केस ऑफ कैंड सालमोन ठीक है देन मैकेनिज्म इज देयर कर्ड इज ए शॉर्ट सॉल्युबल प्रोटीन दैट एक्सूड एंड कोगुलेट्स एंड प्रिसिपिटेट ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द कैंड स्पेशली द सालमोन एंड इफ इट इज नॉट means properly pre-cooked or without pre-cooking if we are using definitely we will face a curd formation ye curd jo form ho jata hai if the curd is formed it will be adhere to the can surface you can see here on the top you can see white dahi jaisa ban gaya hai So this will be stick to your can surface. And while removing that curd from that can surface, during that times, the lacquer portion will also peeled. That lacquer portion will also removed. So that's this curd and adhesion is also a objectionable in can product. Understood?
So यहाँ lacquer भी remove हो जाता है तो फिर से वो problem हो सकता है यहाँ पर sulfide blackening भी हो सकता है.
सुनो सल्फाइड ब्लैकनिंग हमारा कहाँ होता है
वो सिंपल लॉबस्टर क्रैब सिस्टम
मरीन फिशेस जो है
हमारे
मरीन फिशेस
मरीन
ऑक्साइड इन देयर फिश मसल्स
टीएमओ बनाता है
ना ठीक है तो ये कर्ड एनेड है जनरली हमारा सालमोन में ही पाया जाता है कैंड सालमोन जो है
स्पेसिफिक है सालमोन के लिए
हाँ तो ये कैंड साल बेसिकली जो हम ब्राइन यूज करते हैं या सॉल्ट वाटर जो यूज करते हैं सो वो उसमें अगर हम फिश मसल्स को डिप करेंगे तो उसका जो सॉल्ट सॉल्युबल प्रोटीन है दैट विल बी रिलीज्ड अंडरस्टूड दैट सॉल्ट
Yes.
जब वो सॉल्ट सॉल्युबल प्रोटीन रिलीज होगा सो ड्यूरिंग द थर्मल प्रोसेसिंग दिस विल बी कोगुलेटेड एंड प्रेसिपिटेटेड ऑन द टॉप ऑफ द कैन एंड ऑन द टॉप यू कैन सी हियर टॉप ऑफ द कैन सो इट मे स्टिक टू योर कैन सरफेस एंड व्हाइल रिमूविंग दैट कर्ड फ्रॉम द कैन सरफेस दैट टाइम्स लैकर विल रिमूव्ड
Yes.
Understood.
Yes.
तो हमारा ब्लैक सल्फाइड ब्लैकनिंग इधर नहीं होगा ना क्योंकि ये कर्ड फॉर्मेशन इज डिफरेंट एंड सल्फाइड ब्लैकनिंग इज डिफरेंट कर्ड जो एडहेर हो गया है कैन सरफेस से उसको जब तक हम न हटाएं तब तक तो लेकर हमारा एज सच ही रहेगा ना
मैनुअली हटाएंगे तब लेकर निकलेगा मैनुअली निकालेंगे कट को हटाएंगे तब लेकर हट जाएगा
हाँ जब हम कैन ओपन करेंगे तो देखेंगे जो उसमें कर्ड हमारा जो है एडहेर हो चुका है तो इफ यू आर रिमूविंग दैट टाइम देन लेकर विल आल्सो रिमूव्ड अलोंग विद कर्ड
यस
अंडरस्टूड हेलो
यस सर हाँ सर गॉट इट सर
Then preventive measure बोल रहा है preventive measure what we have to do we eat this curd formation we can prevent by cold blanching by using 10 to 50% of brine for 20 to 30 minutes then we have to wash so by doing this we can prevent the curd formation in case of canned salmon now Another problems we are facing in the canned fish and fishery product is the blue discoloration. This is also important and most commonly comes in your competitive exam. Blue discoloration, basically it is associated with a crab meat. Crab meat and causes is due to the formation of copper sulfide. If copper sulfide is formed inside the can, in the meat then you will see the blue color basically ye how it is agar happening generally kya hai jo hamara crab hai fishes they are having a hemoglobin respiratory pigment Whereas the shellfish, they are having a what? Finfish is having a respiratory pigment hemoglobin. Whereas shellfish, they they are having a
hemocyanin.
Hemocyanin.
Good. Because of this hemocyanin, the color of the blood of cell faces will be which color?
Blue color.
क्या आदमी हो यार, ब्लू कलर का ब्लड होता है, कभी लगता है सेल्फिश काटा ही नहीं.
ग्रीन कलर होता है सर.
क्या यार, ब्लू से ग्रीन में चले गए, मतलब अब बोल दो कोई रेड भी.
कलरलेस होता है सर, कलरलेस.
मतलब एनाटॉमी में क्या पढ़े, एनाटॉमी में हम लोग काटते हैं ना मछली को,
स्काइज.
हाँ, एनाटॉमी ऑफ सेलफिश नहीं आया कोर्स. हेलो,
बट हेमोसैनिन में ब्लू कलर ही होता है.
मतलब ब्लू कलर होता है ना. क्या पढ़ते हैं यार ये लोग. अमृत्य, अच्छा मछली जो है, मछली को जो काटते हैं, फिनफिशेस को काटते हैं तो कैसे कलर निकलता है ब्लड से? हेलो,
रेड कलर सर.
तो व्हाई यू आर टेकिंग सो मच टाइम टू टेल दैट फिनफिशेस दे आर हैविंग ए रेड कलर ब्लड एंड इन केस ऑफ सेलफिशेस ब्लड कलर विल बी
कलरलेस.
कलरलेस, आर यू श्योर
सर? व्हाइट सर.
White. Yeah, you are correct. It is a white or colorless. You can white, you can say, not colorless, because white is also one color. So they are having a white color blood. Now mechanism we can see here. So this copper in hemocyanin, in case of hemoglobin, which compound is there?
Iron, sir.
Iron, good. So in hemocyanin, copper is there. So copper in hemocyanin, in crab hemolymph, will react with a sulfur compound, which is liberated during the thermal processing. So from where it is coming, sulfur? It is coming from the sulfur containing amino acid. So copper is there, sulfur compound is there. Both are reacting and forming the copper sulfide. So if this copper and sulfur is reacting and forming the copper sulfide, it will form a blue color. Understood? So this meat of leg, claws, in case of crab, it shows a high incidence of blueing color. And this phenomena will be more prominent when the copper in the meat is having more than 2 mg/cl. अगर कॉपर की मात्रा मोर देन 2 mg/cl से ज्यादा होंगे, देन दिस फेनोमेना विल बी मोर प्रोमिनेंट. सो दिस इज द मैकेनिज्म. अंडरस्टूड? देन प्रिवेंटिव मेजर इज दैट व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू डू द ब्लीडिंग. जो हम क्रैब है, क्रैब को इमीडिएटली हम ब्लीडिंग कराएंगे. ब्लीडिंग कराएंगे तो जो भी हीमोसाइनिन होंगे वो हीमोसाइनिन क्या हो जाएगा, बाहर निकल जाएगा। तो कॉपर का जो लेवल है वो क्या होगा, रिड्यूस हो जाएगा। अनदर ट्रीटमेंट वी हैव टू डू लो टेम्परेचर एंड फ्रैक्शनल हीटिंग। दिस इज व्हाट, देयर इज टू प्रोटीन, वन इज ब्लड प्रोटीन एंड अदर वन इज मीट प्रोटीन। ब्लड प्रोटीन हीमोसाइनिन इज व्हाट, बोल ही नहीं रहा है यार,
ब्लड प्रोटीन,
ब्लड प्रोटीन एंड अनदर वन इज मीट प्रोटीन। सो दिस ब्लड प्रोटीन्स कॉगुलेट्स एट 69 टू 70 डिग्री सी, दैट मींस एट हायर टेम्परेचर इट विल कॉगुलेट कंपेयर टू मीट प्रोटीन। मीट प्रोटीन कॉगुलेट्स एट 59 टू 60 डिग्री सी। सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू, वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड दिस टेम्परेचर, वी हैव टू प्रोवाइड दिस टेम्परेचर। So if we are providing this temperature, so meat protein will coagulate, but blood protein will be as such. So that uncoagulated part of blood, we can easily remove. So if this blood protein, if we are removing, then level of the copper will be reduced. So that is the low temperature and fractional heating. Then another treatment, we have to do the parchment lining. You can see here parchment lining, the same we have to use in the inside the can, parchment lining. And also we can use the chelating agent. What is chelating agent? Chelating agent. Hello?
EDTA, sir.
Huh?
EDTA.
Correct. So, by using chelating agent in the brine and maintenance of proper acidity, can control the blue discoloration phenomena in Kingish of crab meat. Okay? Another problem we are facing is the honeycombing. Honeycombing basically associated with a canned meat. And if that meat is processed from the still raw material, that means already pehle se raw material jo hai wo fresh nahi hai, means kharab ho gaya. So from if we are using such type of raw materials, we will face the honeycombing. So mechanism you can see here, what is happening during steaming process, because we are providing heat and steam, so meat will contract. How the meat is contracting? Because they are removing the water and protein coagulation will occur. Okay, then from the water which is present inside the fish tissue or inner portion of the fish meat, so during that thermal processing, that water will evaporate. Andar se pani evaporate hokar ke surface pe aayega. Surface pe aane ke baad mein wo kya karega? Gas or bubble like. You can see escape as a gas or bubbles through the soft, not yet coagulated part, and the gelatinous part swell like a bubble or soap bubble. ठीक है, वो आके सरफेस पे means gas bubble, you can say gas or bubble like structure will form at the gelatinous layer. And it will be solidified on the surface after cooling, and that is your honeycombing. You can see here honeycombing. अच्छा अभी हमारा ये टाइम खत्म हो रहा है, ये आई थिंक ये खत्म हो जाएगा तो फिर से ज्वाइन करना है क्योंकि और थोड़ा सा बचा हुआ है. देन ओके हनीकॉम्बिंग अंडरस्टैंड अंडरस्टूड.
यस सर.
ये खत्म हो रहे हैं, एक मिनट फिर से शेयर करना पड़ेगा. Okay, then another one is the softening in shrimp. So basically it is associated with a canned shrimp. And what is the causes? Causes due to the decomposition of the protein to soluble non-protein component. So that usually occurs in the raw materials when freshness declines. So basically this is the decomposition. Decomposition of proteins to soluble non-protein component. So that is the causes. Because of that, the meat will be soft.